Radiohead are a great example of a band who make technically sophisticated music, which still remains accessible and musical. And their time signatures are a great example of this creativity. So let's start by looking at one of my favourite songs by Radiohead, 15 Step. In an interview in the August 2006 issue of Mojo magazine, Thom Yorke said, "There's a track called 15 Step which was born out of a mad rhythm experiment that we did last year. It's got a bass line like Airbag and it's in 5/4 time with this clapping groove throughout." The 15 Step is in 5/4, but it actually goes a little bit further than that, it gets more interesting than that. See, the thing is, in any time signature, you can arrange the accents a bit differently to achieve different feels whilst remaining in the same time signature. Let me show you an example in 4/4. So here we have the piano riff from Clocks by Coldplay, and it's in 4/4 time, but the accents are arranged in a 3/3/2 pattern. So we get an emphasis on the first beat, on the 2 and on the 4. You can hear the difference even more clearly in this example that I've made. The first two bars are in a simple 4/4 time, but the latter two bars are in what's called a tracillo rhythm. The whole thing is in 4/4, but there's a totally different feel in the second two bars. So the way that you arrange your accents in your time signature can really change how it feels, and 15 Step takes good advantage of this. A lot of songs that are written in 5/4 arrange the accents in a group of 3 and a group of 2, so you get 1-2-3, 1-2, 1-2-3, 1-2. This is the group of accents that's used in Take 5 by the Dave Brubeck Quartet. One way of conceptualizing this is that you could write it as a bar of 3/4 and a bar of 2/4, like this. But 15 Step actually avoids this typical pattern and uses its own 2-bar pattern. In the first bar, we get an accent on the 1, followed by 4 standard crotchets. But the second bar is really interesting. We get another accent on the 1, but this time instead of the 4 crotchets, we get this syncopated rhythm, which is basically just a tracillo, which is that Latin Caribbean rhythm that I've mentioned before. This tracillo rhythm that's in the second half of the pattern makes the bar feel like it's slowing down compared to the bar before it, because the hits are more spaced out. So 15 Step winds up with this 2-bar rhythmic pattern that feels like it's constantly speeding up and slowing down again. This 2-bar pattern that serves as the foundation of 15 Step's rhythm is very reminiscent of what's called a clave, especially as it's clapped out, like claves often are. Claves are the traditional rhythmic patterns that Afro-Cuban music is often based on. One of the most famous claves is the son clave. Claves provide a consistent framework for the rest of the song to be built on. They help the groove to continue ticking over as other ideas come in. And this is definitely what happens in 15 Step. Any time that this clave rhythm drops out, you can really feel how the rhythm has become a lot more loose and floating. And then when it re-enters again, the song feels a lot more nailed down to this 5/4 time. That's for whatever. Everything in its right place is a great example of changing between time signatures to create an unusual feeling. Now, most of the time I've seen this song written down as a bar of 6/4 and then a bar of 4/4. but it doesn't actually have to be notated that way. The thing is, what we know for sure is that the main riff or phrase contains 10 crotchet beats. But there are different ways that we can write down those 10 crotchet beats into time signatures. You could just plainly write it out as a 10-4 phrase. But maybe it's better to conceptualize it as two bars of 4-4 and then another half bar. Or maybe, my favorite, is a half bar sandwiched between two bars of 4-4. So you go 4-4, 2-4, 4-4. Really, in practice, it doesn't matter that much which one you use. It's all about making it as clear to read as possible and communicating the rhythm to the person who's trying to play it. Now, everything in its right place has more than just this weird 10-beat riff. When we hit the verse, we now get a couple moments where instead of shifting from 6-4 to 4-4, we lose a beat and we shift from 5-4 to 4-4. Now at this point we've got so used to this 6-4-4-4 pattern, this 10 beat riff, that when we get this brief moment of 5-4 when we get a 9 beat riff instead, it makes the music feel like it's skipping or tripping over. Now all this swapping between time signatures or swapping between different lengths of phrase definitely helps give Everything in Its Right Place its weird uncanny rhythmic feel, which is very ironic for a song called Everything in Its Right Place. Now let's move on to a different example, Morning Bell, which is a really interesting song because it was released twice, once on Kid A and then on the next album, Amnesiac. And why it's so interesting is on Kid A, it's in 5-4, but on Amnesiac, it's in 4-4. So when I first realised this, it took me a while to work out how they'd so seamlessly compressed a 5-4 song into 4-4. And really what they've done is taken any of the long held out notes like these and just made them a little bit shorter. All of the other notes, and therefore all of the other lyrics, still fall on the same beats that they did before, so the song keeps the same character even though it's changed into a different time signature. For example, the word the in both time signatures comes on the quaver before the bar begins, and the word bell comes on the last beat of the bar. As to why there's two different versions, Ed O'Brien said, "We often record different versions of songs, and Morning Bell is the first time it has been strong enough to bear hearing again. Most of the other versions often get scrapped halfway through." The last example we're going to look at today is Paranoid Android. Now, most of Paranoid Android remains in a normal 4-4 time. However, there's a section later that moves back and forth from 7-8 to 4-4. Because this section keeps moving back and forth from 7-8 to 4-4 instead of just staying in 7-8, it stops the 7-8 time from developing its own groove and instead keeps reminding us of the contrast between 7-8 and 4-4. Because 7-8 is just one quaver note shorter than 4-4, it makes the 7-8 sound like it's ending prematurely, like each bar is glitching out, it's sort of skipping the last note. So when we get the 4-4, we get the fully actualized version. And a similar effect is achieved in Mike Oldfield's famous Tubular Bells piano riff. See, the Tubular Bells riff alternates between a 14-note version and a 16-note version. So each time we hear the 14-note version, it sounds like it skipped the end, and then the 16-note version is really satisfying because we hear the whole thing. I've seen this riff actually written down in many different time signatures before, but I've written it down here as one bar of 7-4 and then another bar of 8-4 to show you how the first bar is like the second bar, but cut short. Anyway, back to Paranoid Android. So this whole section keeps moving back and forth from 7-8 to 4-4. When Tom's vocals come in, for example, we're in 4-4, and then when we go back to the riff, we're in 7-8 again. And this constant moving back and forth really plays into this chaos that's being created in this section. All of this dynamic pressure building up and is finally relieved in this held out F chord at the end. So anyway, that was just four examples of Radiohead's great use of time signature. Obviously, as you can imagine, there's a lot more out there. Now, if there's any particular examples that you really like, please leave a comment below because I'd love to explore a bit more about what Radiohead have been doing with time signature.
Idea was the jazz used to challenge the public and make them think in terms more advanced rhythmically than they were used to thinking. It's time that the jazz musicians take up their original role of leading the public into a more adventurous rhythms.
And you think this is what is now going to take place?
Well, the Take Five is proof of it.
Mm-hmm.
After all, the kids are tired of rock and roll, too.
Mm-hmm.
And yet they can dance in 5-4 time.